أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. بسم الله أوله وآخره. فلولا كان من القرون من قبلكم أولو بقية ينهون عن الفساد في الأرض إلا قليلا ممن أنجينا منهم واتبع الذين ظلموا ما أترفوا فيه وكانوا مجرمين. If only there were among the generations before you men possessing a remnant of wisdom, prohibiting their people from corruption in the earth, except only a few among them, whom we delivered. These nations, when they were destroyed, what was the main quality? Very few people remained on the right path, and they were also not forbidding from something wrong. So then you know the nation becomes liable to the final extermination, the final punishment. But those people who go on forbidding, a few, they are saved. أَنْجَيْنَا مِنْهُمْ وَاتَّبَعَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مَا أُتْرِفُوا وَكَانُوا مُجْرِمِينَ. And these evildoers, they always followed their luxuries. أُتْرِفُوا فِي, what we had given them, the luxuries of this life. They were after them all the time. وَكَانُوا مُجْرِمِينَ, and they were definitely guilty. وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ لِيُهْلِكَ الْقُرَى بِظُلْمٍ وَأَهْلُهَا مُصْلِحُونَ. And your Lord is not such that he would have destroyed these towns, these big cities and civilizations, and the people thereof, even if the people thereof were muslihun, righteous, reformers. وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَجْعَلَ النَّاسَ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا. And if your Lord had decreed so, he could have made the all mankind one community, all Muslims, the best Muslims. وَلَا يَزَالُونَ مُخْتَلِفِينَ. But they will continue to have differences and disagreements. Now this is very important, you know. Every person feels, why this, you know, disagreement? Why these differences? Why we are, you know, so much divided among ourselves? Why these sects? Why these schisms, etc., etc.? So every good-natured person abhors these things, doesn't like these things. But now one thing is very important. The philosophy is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given people a freedom of choice, because he has created this world for you, and the life here is actually a period of testing. Number one, خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Number two, testing necessitates freedom of choice. There could be no testing if there is no freedom of choice. And freedom of choice, the inevitable result is difference of opinion. So don't, you know, be so much grieved over that. Very important words are coming. وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَجَعَلَ النَّاسَ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً وَلَا يَزَالُونَ مُخْتَلِفِينَ إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبُّكَ وَلِذَٰلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created them on this pattern. This is the basic theme of the philosophy of this creation. This creation is for testing. Testing necessitates freedom of choice. And the inevitable result, you might be not like it, but the inevitable result of freedom of choice is differences. So this will continue. You know, there should be some limits. You should try to limit your differences. Or, you, as we say, we should agree to disagree. And we should accommodate the difference of opinion. These things are, they are, have to be kept under, within certain limits. Not that we, you know, become enemies to each other, we are quarreling with each other. Man digram tu digri, I am something else, you are something else. Not to that type. Accommodate the difference of opinion. Illa marrahim arabbuk, except whom your Lord, you know, shows mercy. وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. And the word of your Lord is going to be fulfilled, that I will fill Jahannam with the jinns and the mankind, all of them. So if there is no difference of opinion, if don't, people or jinns don't go astray, then who will fill the Jahannam then? So actually this is the end result. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the very beginning, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَكَ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكَ وَمِمَّنْ تَبَعَكَ. We find these words in Surah Bani Israel. Now the final concluding remarks, as we may call, concluding ayat of this surah, وَكُلَّنْ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ. Now this is the term which I have been using, you know. This is the place from which this term has been derived. كُلَّنْ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ. All these big news of the messengers of Allah which we are relating to you, مَا نُصَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ, with which we are strengthening your heart and of hearts of those who are with you, so that they should come to know. All messengers were persecuted. All messengers were mocked upon. All messengers had to go, messengers of Allah had to undergo, you know, hardships. But in the end, all of the messengers were saved and delivered. They were successful. So these things, you know, are coming to you in these stories, or these tales of the history. وَجَاكَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَقُّ وَمَوْعِظَةٌ وَذِكْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. هَذِهِ means these tales, these qasas, in these stories. وَجَاكَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَقُّ. In these, to you have come the truth, the total truth. وَمَوْعِظَةٌ, the sermon. وَذِكْرَى, and a reminding for all those who believe. وَقُلْ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ عَمَلُوا عَلَىٰ مَكَانَتِكُمْ إِنَّا عَامِلُونَ. And so to say to those who are not believing, who are rejecting you, عَمَلُوا عَلَىٰ مَكَانَتِكُمْ, you do whatever you can do. You strive your utmost. إِنَّا عَامِلُونَ. We are also doing it, and we shall strive our utmost. But the point to be noted here is, إِنِّي has now changed into إِنَّا. We have been reading, Inni Aamil, I'malu ala makanatikum, Inni Aamil. You go on doing whatever you want to do, at your own place, to your utmost, both meanings of this makanatikum. Inni Aamil, I am also doing it. But here it is, from Inni to Inna. What does it mean? From an individual, now a community, a party, a group has emerged. This is actually the process of da'wah. One individual starts, I am going to do this. This is my path. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. Now, in due course of time, if he is not dejected, maybe for some time nobody listens to him, people are mocking at him, you know, people, you know, are making, cutting jokes at him, so on. It might go on for some time. But he has to be perseverance. He has to show perseverance, be steadfast, be firm, continue with it. Then, you know, surely, maybe slowly, but gradually people will come, gather round him. And this inni will turn into inna. As Allama Iqbal has said very beautifully, Gaye din ke tanha tha main anjuman mein, yahan ab mere razdaan aur bhi hain. This is the course, you know, of a da'wah. Wa inna amilun, muntaziru, inna muntazirun. And go, wait, you also, and we are also waiting. وَلِلَّهِ غَيْبُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And to Allah belongs all the unseen of the heavens and the earth. There is much unseen in the earth also. We don't know the whole of the earth. And what is inside the earth? We have some knowledge of until some depth. But what is further down? We don't know. So actually, there is a lot of unseen in this world also. وَلِلَّهِ غَيْبُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَإِلَيْهِ يَرْجُعُ الْأَمْرُ يُرْجَعُ الْأَمْرُ كُلُّهُ. And to him will be returned all the matters for final decision. فَعْبُدْهُ. So, worship him, love him, serve him, be a bondsman to him. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَيْهِ. And have trust in him, have faith in him, have confidence in him. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِغَافِلٍ أَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. And your Lord is not unaware of what they are doing. With this we come to the end of Surah Hud, and now we have to start with Surah Yusuf. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألف لام را تلك آيات الكتاب المبين. إنا أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا لعلكم تعقلون. نحن نقص عليك أحسن القصص بما أوحينا إليك هذا القرآن وإن كنت من قبله لمن الغافلين. صدق الله العظيم. Now this Surah Yusuf, which comprises of 111 ayat, divided into 12 sections. This Surah Al-Mubarakah is very peculiar in many respects. One aspect I told you, that now these surahs, which are following, Makki surahs, they are 14 in number, starting from Surah Yunus, ending with Surah Al-Mu'minun in the 18th part. These are 14 surahs. And 12 of them are in subgroups of 3 surahs each. Among every group, there are 2 surahs which are like a pair, very similar to each other, reciprocal to each other. All those things, you know, they exist, those points of similarity also, and reciprocity also. But one is peculiar, which has no pair. So here we found Surah Yunus, Surah Hud, alayhi salatu wassalam. They were a pair, a very beautiful pair, a complete pair. Similarities, reciprocities, all present. But Surah Yusuf is a peculiar surah. It is unique in many respects. Number one, it is unique that whole of this surah contains the story, or we may call it the biography, of one prophet of Allah. Whole of it. Quite a big, quite a sizable surah, 12 sections. But, you know, except a few ayat in the beginning and a few ayat in the end, whole of the surah is devoted to the story of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wassalam. And that is the title of this surah, Surah Yusuf. Number two, there is only one example more in the whole of Quran which is devoted exclusively to one messenger of Allah. No mention of anyone else in that, and that is Surah Taha. That is also included in this very group. Surah Taha will come after Surah Maryam. You know, this is also in that 2/3 of that surah, nearly 2/3 is, you know, occupied by the story of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. Now what is peculiar? During the lifetime of Hazrat Yusuf, Bani Israel entered Egypt. And at the time of Hazrat Musa, they came out from Egypt. So one full surah devoted to that incident, and one surah devoted to that incident of Exodus, as they call it. The book of Exodus is a very full book in the Old Testament. But the difference is, Yusuf alayhi salatu wassalam was a Nabi, not a messenger. You won't find in the whole surah that type of thing, you believe me, you obey me, if you don't obey me, if you don't believe me, justice will come to you, you'll be exterminated. You know, nothing of this. Just like, you know, a saint, a very pious person, you know, a very, so to say, Waliullah, a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only difference being, I told you, the only difference between Nabi and Wali is that to Wali, the revelations don't come. Nabi, to Nabi, revelations have been coming. That's all. Otherwise, their behavior is very similar to each other. They must, you know, all the awliya Allah, they have been making da'wah to people so that they become good. Ya'muruna bil ma'ruf, yanhauna 'anil munkar, all these things they have to do. This is actually absolutely natural, logical. But no special appointment. Fadhhab ila fir'aun innahu tagha. Now this is an appointment. Go to him. So it actually, that is now a Nabi when he is appointed to a particular people, to a particular region, to a particular city, now he becomes a Rasul. Now his, you know, behavior is absolutely different. You have to believe in me. You will have to obey me. أَنِعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَاتِيعُونَ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا بِرَسُولٍ إِلَّا لِيُطَاعَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. So the conduct of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam, Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wassalam is a very beautiful example of a person who was a Nabi only, not a Rasul. And you know the difference in their behavior, in their attitude, very remarkable. Third thing about this surah which must be mentioned in the beginning is that this surah was revealed to answer a question which was put to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by the Quraysh of Makkah on the instigation of Yahud, the Jews of Medina. Ask him, what were the circumstances in which Bani Israel went to Egypt? They didn't belong to Egypt. Why did they go there? What's the history? What were the circumstances which led to their going to Egypt? So this question was put to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now this whole surah was revealed, but in a very beautiful way. So that not only the question was answered, but a mirror was shown to the Quraysh at Makkah. What happened to Yusuf is going to happen to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are plotting against him, لَيُسْبِتُوكَ أَوْ يُخْرِجُوكَ أَوْ يَقْتُلُوكَ. Should we kill him? Should we imprison him? Should we expel him? These were the parley, you know, the consultation going on at Makkah. The same way the brothers of Yusuf, they were also, you know, discussing among themselves what to do, how to do away with this person, Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. You will ask, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will stay in Ghar Sawr. And Yusuf was thrown in a well. But from Ghar Sawr, Muhammad went straight to Medina, and he entered Medina as an unthroned king. In the same way, from this well, Yusuf was taken out, and he entered Egypt, and in course of time, he became the most powerful person in that country. And in the same way, that you know the brothers of Yusuf had to stand before Yusuf in humiliation. One day will surely come when you, O Quraysh, will be standing before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he will say to you the same words as Yusuf said to his brothers, La tasrib alaykum al-yawm. Izhabu fantum al-tulaqa. So history is repeating itself. So that is actually, these are, you know, then there are very different issues also which we shall discuss. But these basic points must be noted before we start the study of the text. Alif Lam Ra, the third surah, consecutive surah, which is starting with these three letters, Alif Lam Ra. Surah Yunus, Surah Hud, before this, also began with these. And I pointed out to you, these words, these letters here are not counted as an ayah. Alif Lam Meem in Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Meem in Surah Ali Imran are counted in one ayah. Alif Lam Ra is not. But it is not based on any principle of logic, any principle of grammar, nothing of that sort. It is all taqifi. As the Prophet said, we take it. Tilka ayatul kitab al-mubin. These are the ayat of a book which is very clear, manifest. Inna anzalnahu Qur'anan Arabiyan. We have sent it down as an Arabic Qur'an. Now, who? What is this pronoun, objective mood of the pronoun? The real book is there. Fi lawhim mahfuz, kitabim maknoon, fi ummul kitab ladayna al-aliyyul hakeem. Now, when we have sent down it to you, we have made it a book, a Quran in Arabic language. You don't know what language is there. Allah's language, you know. Actually, we don't know. But this, had this Quran been revealed to any other nation, having another language, it would have been revealed in that language also. Torah was given in Hebrew. Injil, we don't know, absolutely don't know in which language it was revealed. Because we don't find any original text of Injil in Hebrew, nor in Aramaic, nor in Syriac. And these are the only three languages which could be the original language of Injil. But no copy, no text is to be found. The earliest copy of Injil is a Greek translation. Now, Injil could not have been sent down in Greek, because Greek was not the language of the area where Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam lived. So it couldn't be that. It would have been Greek to them, as we say, you know, idiomatically. It's all Greek for him. But it would have been Greek for them. So actually, it must have been sent either in Hebrew or in Syriac or the Aramaic language. But we don't have, they don't claim to have any text in those original languages. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down, inna ja'alnahu, we have made it Qur'anan Arabiyan. The Qur'an, Arabic Qur'an, la'allakum ta'akilun, so that you may understand it. Who are they, you? The people of Arabia. Who were the first addressees of Qur'an? To whom the advent, to them the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was al-baisatul khasa, exclusively. Special, you know, advent was for the people of Arabia. نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ عَصْرَ الْقَصَصِ. We narrate to you the best narrations. بِمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. With that, what we have sent down to you and we have revealed to you this Qur'an. وَإِن كُنْتَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ لَمِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ. Surely, before this, you were also absolutely unaware from among the unawares. Just as your nation didn't know, you also didn't know. Istala Yusuf ul Abihi. Now who is Yusuf? Please note here, you must be knowing. Son of Yaqub, who was son of Ishaq, who was son of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. So grandson of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam. Grandson, we should say. Istala Yusuf ul Abihi. Who is Abi? And he is Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam. يَا بَتَيْنِي رَأَيْتُ أَحَدَ عَشَرَ كَوْكَبًا وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ رَأَيْتُهُمْ لِي سَاجِدِينَ. Oh my father, I saw in my dream, in my vision, 11 stars and the sun and the moon prostrating before me. قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تَخْصُصْ رُؤْيَاكَ عَلَىٰ إِخْوَتِكَ. He said, the father said, oh my son, dear son, don't relate this vision of yours to your brothers. There were 11 brothers of yours. Two of them, they were the youngest, Hazrat Yusuf bin Yameen, and they were from the same mother. The elder 10, you know, they were from different mothers, but they were one group. And they were all, you know, united against these two. Because being the youngest, they were more dear. They were more focused of attention of father, Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam. So they had developed a jealousy. So that was, you know, the cause of that enmity, that jealousy. وَإِسْقَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تَخْصُصْ رُؤْيَاكَ عَلَىٰ إِخْوَتِكَ فَيَكِيدُوا لَكَ كَيْدًا. They will plot against you and devise against you a device, a plot. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ. Verily, Satan is for humans, for mankind, a very clear enemy. وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ. Now he is giving the what was the interpretation of this dream. You will be chosen. Out of my sons, you will be chosen as Nabi. Ijtiba and istifa, these are two very closely related words. That is why we use these two words about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ahmad Mujtaba. And both have very similar, you know, connotation. To choose someone, to select someone. But there is a difference in choice and selection. But I can't go into detail. So this ijtiba and istifa is for the prophets. وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ. And this dream, you know, shows that you will be chosen by your Lord. وَيُعَلِّمُكَ مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. And he will teach you the interpretations of all things. Ahadith, you know, usually people think that visions and dreams. No. Hadasa means anything which happens. Hadasa, an accident. Whether it is an accident or an incident or a saying, Hadithul Rasul. Hadithullah, فَبِأَيِّ حَدِيثٍ بَعْدَهُ يُؤْمِنُونَ. This is Hadith of Allah. So all the sayings, all the statements, all the incidents, all the accidents, all the dreams, all the visions, they are all included in this word Ahadith. He will teach you the interpretation and to reach to the basic thing in every statement, in every saying, in every dream, in every vision, in every imagination, etc., etc. وَيُتِمُّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَىٰ عَلَىٰ يَعْقُوبَ. And he will perfect his blessing on you and the progeny of Yaqub. كَمَا أَتَمَّهَا عَلَىٰ أَبَوَيْكَ. As he perfected it on your forefathers min qabl, before Ibrahim wa Ishaq. That is Ibrahim and Ishaq alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And he didn't name himself out of humility. It was not good, you know, that he should have named himself also. Ibrahim, Abu Ishaq, Abu Yaqub. But he was himself speaking, so he omitted his name. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. Verily, your Lord is all-knowing, all-wise. لقد كان في يوسف وإخوته آيات للسائلين. Verily, in this you know, the story of Yusuf and his brothers are signs for those who are asking. They will see a mirror. A mirror will be presented to them because the Quraysh asked the question. Actually, those who instigated were the Jews. But to Prophet ﷺ came the Quraysh. Now actually, both of them, you know, the Quraysh as well as the Jews, they had been given this mirror. You can see your picture and you can see the picture of Muhammad ﷺ. The role, the same role as of Yusuf is now today of Muhammad ﷺ. And the role that was of the brothers of Yusuf is of these chieftains of Quraysh and the Jews of Medina. إِذْ قَالُوا لَيُوسُفُ وَأَخُوهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَىٰ أَبِينَا مِنَّا. When they said, verily Yusuf وَأَخُوهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَىٰ أَبِينَا مِنَّا. Yusuf and his brother are more dear to our father than us. وَنَحْنُ عُصْبَى. Although we are a strong group. Now this word, you know, عُصْبَى, strong group. We are a strong group. So actually, he should love us more. We can protect him. At any time of emergency, we can come to his help. So he should show more affection towards us. But what we see that he loves these two youngsters who can't be of any help. Inna abana lafi dalalim mubin. Verily, our father seems to be in a manifest error. Uqtulu Yusufa. Avitrahuhu ardan yakhlu lakum wajhu abikum. Now either kill Yusuf or expel him into some other land so that the attention of your father now becomes exclusively for you. The same thing. لَيُسْبِتُوكَ أَوْ يَقْتُلُوكَ أَوْ يُخْرِجُوكَ. Either they should imprison you or you kill you or expel you. The same thing. اُقْتُلُوا يُوسُفَ أَبِتْرَحُوهُ أَرْضٌ يَخْلُ لَكُمْ وَجْهُ أَبِيكُمْ وَتَكُونُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ قَوْمًا صَالِحِينَ. And after that you become the righteous man, you know. So this is a usual thing which our nafs, you know, tells us. Well, you know, take this bitter pill. Then you can repent. You can, you know, mend your ways. Afterwards you become a good man. But at this time you have to do it. Although it is very bad, it is something wicked, it is something haram, it is forbidden, but I have to do it. So take this bitter pill at this time at least, but then later on, you become righteous and you become the all gentle. قَالَ قَائِلٌ مِّنْهُمْ لَا تَقْتُلُوا يُوسُفَ. So said one who said from amongst them, لَا, don't kill, لَا تَقْتُلُوا يُوسُفَ, don't kill Yusuf. وَالْقُوهُ فِي غَيَابَةِ الْجُبُّ. You just throw him in some well. يَلْتَقِتْهُ بَعْضُ السَّيَّارَةِ. He will be taken from there, taken out from there by some caravan, travelers. إِن كُنْتُمْ فَاعِلِينَ. If you are bent upon doing something. You know, among them was also some sinners, you know, advice. He was the eldest. And he said, you know, he was the most gentle among them. First of all, don't kill. And if you are bent upon doing it, because now we are a group, if you, majority of you want to do something, well, I can't resist. But if you are bent upon doing something, then only you throw him some well, so that some caravan comes, when they will draw water, Yusuf will come out, and they will take him, you know, to some other land. قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا مَا لَكَ لَا تَعْمَنَّا عَلَىٰ يُوسُفَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَنَاصِحُونَ. They said, oh, our father, what's with you? What's the cause? That you don't trust us regarding Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam. Wa inna lahu lanasir. We are most sincere well-wishers to him. You think we are enemies to him? No, no. We are most sincere. We are his well-wishers. But you don't trust us. Arsilu ma'ana yarta' wa yal'ab. Send him tomorrow with us so that he should eat and play. We are going out hunting. We should also, you know, when one goes out, can have some wild fruit, you know, from the jungle and so on. So he'll play. أَرْسِلُوا مَعَنَا غَدًا يَتَعْيَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. And we shall be protectors. We promise. We shall protect him. قال انی لیحزنونی ان تذهبوا به واخاف ان یاکلہ الذئب وانتم عنہ غافلون. He said it very much grieves me. Maybe that you take him with you and then you become unaware of him, heedless about him, and some wolf comes and eats him and devours him. As if he himself gave the hint, you know, what to do and what to say. قَالُوا لَيْنَ قَلَهُ الزِّيبُ وَنَحْنُ رُسْبَةُ إِنَّا إِذَا لَّخَاسِرُونَ. They said, oh, father, look to it. We are a strong group, 10 of us, 11 now, because Benjamin is also to go with us. Now, in our presence, if a wolf can come and eat him and devour him, then we are in a loss. We are nothing. We are meaningless then. فَلَمَّا ذَهَبُوا بِهِ. When they went with him, took him out, وَأَجْمَعُوا, that is mean, أَجْمَعُوا كَيْدَهُمْ. They gathered, you know, their will and decision, and they agreed upon it. أَنْ يَجْعَلُوهُ فِي غِيَابَةِ الْجُبِّ, that they should put him in that depths of that well. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِ, and we put it in his heart. Now, wahi here, you know, it is not the wahi of Nabuwa. أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِ, it is just like the wahi to the, even, you know, the honey bee, you know, the also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so يُوحِي رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ. In the same way, it's an inspiration, not revelation. We inspired him. لَتُنَبِّئَنَّهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِمْ هَذَا. Oh Yusuf, don't fear. A time will come. You will tell them that they did this to you. You will inform them what they are doing. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ, and they are knowing nothing what they are doing. Or they will not be absolutely knowing that you are Yusuf. It's a reference to know what will happen in the end. That you will tell them what you did with Yusuf. So actually in this there was a solace for Yusuf. You will not be killed. You will not be wasted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthened his heart. Take heart. We are with you. A time will come when you will inform them what they are doing to you today. وَجَاؤُوا أَبَاهُمْ عِشَاءً يَبْكُونَ. And they came to their father at the nightfall weeping. قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا إِنَّا ذَهَبْنَا نَسْتَبِقُ. And they said, oh, our father, we went away racing with each other. وَتَرَكْنَا يُوسُفَ عِنَّا مَتَاعِنَا. And we left Yusuf with our goods, our clothes, clothing, etc., etc., goods. فَأَكَلَهُ الذِّئْبُ. And a wolf ate him up, devoured him. وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ لَنَا وَلَوْ كُنَّا صَادِقِينَ. You are not going to believe us. Although we might be absolutely truthful, but you will never believe it. وَجَاؤُوا عَلَىٰ قَمِيصِهِ بِدَمٍ كَذِبٍ. And they brought on the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam false blood. قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ أَمْرًا. Hazrat Yaqub said, your minds have enticed you to invent this matter. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. So for me, it's the time to have patience and beautiful patience. He could be, you know, hot. He could be furious. He could abuse them. Everything could be done. But صَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ, beautiful. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَىٰ مَا تَصِفُونَ. You know, as the command came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَاسْبِرْ عَلَىٰ مَا يَقُولُونَ وَحْجُرْهُمْ هَجْرًا جَمِيلًا. So you have patience on whatever they are saying. You have to bear it. And you should, you know, leave them. But this leaving should not be in a very beautiful way, so that you can meet again. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَىٰ مَا تَصِفُونَ. And only Allah can be called for help on what you are describing. وَجَاءَتْ سَيَّارَةٌ. And as the brother had said, a caravan of travelers came. فَأَرْسَلُوا وَارِدَهُمْ. They sent ahead their water drawer. فَأَدْلَىٰ دَلْوَهُ. And that person, the water drawer, he sent down his bucket. قَالَ يَا بُشْرَىٰ هَذَا غُلَامٌ. And he said, oh, congratulations. Good tidings. There we have found a youth. هَذَا غُلَامٌ وَأَسَرُّهُ بِضَاعَةٍ. And they hid him as a merchandise. So now we can sell him. We can make money from him. So they hid him. Wallahu alimu bima ya'malun, and Allah was, Allah knew what they were doing. And Allah himself intended that it should be done, because he had to be taken to Egypt. How could he go by himself to Egypt? The caravan was heading towards Egypt. وَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودَةٍ. And they sold him for a paltry price, a few counted dirhams. وَكَانُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الزَّاهِدِينَ. And they were very ascetic regarding the demanding of their price, because they had not paid anything. It was just free for them. Had they paid some money, they would have included that, you know, cost, and then added to that cost their own profit. But here they found it without any price, so they accepted a very low price also. وَقَالُ الَّذِي اشْتَرَاهُ مِنْ مِصْرِ. Now we come to Misr. Now some of the Egyptologists, they have, you know, fixed the year of the entrance of Yusuf into Egypt as 1890 before Christ. And it seems to be like that, because, you know, 2000 years or so, 2000 plus, was the era of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, 2000 plus before Christ. And now, because he is the great-grandson of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, and he was 17 at this age when he was thrown in the well and he was taken out and then he was sold, that was the 17th year of his age. And it was the year 1890 before Christ. وَقَالَ الَّذِي اشْتَرَاهُ مِنْ مِصْرِ. Now they brought him to the market of the slaves in Egypt and said the person who bought him, who purchased him in Misr, in Egypt, لِمْرَاتِهِ, to his wife, أَكْرَمِي مَسْوَى. Make his lodgings goodly. أَسَى يَنْفَعْنَا. Maybe that he gives us some benefit. We can sell him for a higher price. أَوْ نَتَّخِذَهُ وَلَدًا. And it can also be possible that we adopt him as a son. They didn't have any son. وَكَذَلِكَ مَكَّنَّا لِيُوسُفْ. And this is how we establish Yusuf in the land, fil ard. Now, you know, it was a cradle of civilization. It was an empire. And this person, you know, he was Al-Aziz. So to say, the chief executive officer. Maybe in our terminology, the prime minister. Or the senior minister in this system of, you know, for example, in French system, senior chief minister. So he was having a very big position. And now he was lodged in his house, and people were coming over there, high gentry, aristocrats coming, you know, and talking, and he was listening to them. So actually he was trained over there for all the political affairs, all the affairs of community, and all what are the problems, how they are set, how they are, you know, resolved, how can they be solved. So all these things, because he was lodged in the house of the chief executive of Egypt. وَكَذَلِكَ مَكَّنَّا لِيُوسُفَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلِنُعَلِّمَهُ مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. Being there in that high society, at that house, because whenever some visitors would be coming to Al-Aziz of Misr, you know, he would call upon Yusuf, okay, bring this for him and for them, and, you know, serve them, and so on. So he was always listening to what was happening. In that way, he gained the capability of interpreting all things, you know. Something is appearing to be something else, and behind is something else. To know what is behind it, that is the Ta'wilul Ahadith. You go to the root, to the background. What is the real cause? What is the underlying cause? So that is actually Ta'wilul Ahadith. لِنُعَلِّمَهُ مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِ. And surely Allah is all-powerful over His command and over His decisions. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people don't know it. They think what we are doing is best, and it will happen as we are designing it and devising it to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may use your ill designs against a person in a way that it becomes beneficial for him. وَرَاوَدَتْهُ الَّتِي هُوَ فِي بَيْتِهَا نَفْسِهِ. And the woman in whose house he was lodged, the wife of Al-Aziz, she sought to seduce him sexually. ولما بلغ اشدہ آتینا حکمًا وعلمًا. And when he reached his maturity, about 18 or 19 years of age, mature, آتینا حکمًا وعلمًا, we gave him the judgment and the knowledge, the wisdom and the knowledge. وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِ الْمُحْسَنِينَ, and in this way, we reward the people who do good or who are best in their deen. وَرَاوَدَتْهُ الَّتِي هُوَ فِي بَيْتِهَا نَفْسِهِ, and a woman in whose house he was, she tried to seduce him sexually. وَغَلَّقَتْ الْأَبْوَابَ, and she closed the doors. وَقَالَتْ هَيْتَ لَكَ, and said, come on. قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ, he said, my refuge is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I take refuge in Allah. إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايَ, he is my Lord, and he has, you know, kept me here in the best of the ways. My lodging in best way. Now there is a different opinion. Rabbi means either Allah or the master. Because the master, you know, who has bought him. This was also an idiom of that time, that he is the Rabb, he is the Lord. This will be used by Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam to his two companions of the prison. And this word is used for your king or your master, Rabb. So this Rabb, you know, has a very broad meaning. Rabbul Mal, the owner of the capital. Rabbul Bayt, the owner of the house. So actually the Rabb, he was the master, the Aqa, to whom he was a bondsman because he had bought him. Innahu ahsana rabbi masa, I can't do this against him. You are his wife. And he kept me in the best of the ways. Innahu la yuflihu zalimun, verily, the evildoers can never prosper. وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا, and certainly she besought him, and he would also have besought her. لَوْلَا رَى بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ, had he not seen the burhan of his Lord, of his Rabb. Now what is that burhan? Generally it is said that there was a miracle, that on the wall appeared the figure of Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam, and he forbade him, don't hold yourself. But you know, Abdullah Yusuf Ali has explained it in a very different way. And I think it's a beautiful way. I can't say that it is the only way, but it is a beautiful way. She was blind with passions and emotions. But Yusuf was spiritually, he was seeing. So actually this was the burhan. He saw Allah. Because spiritually he believed in Allah. She only thought that nobody is seeing, because I have already closed the doors. And she was blind due to passions. But you know, Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, because he believed in Allah, who always sees, you are always in his sight. So that was the burhan according to Abdullah Yusuf Ali, and Allah better knows. كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءَ, and it was so that we should turn away from him the evil and indecency and all shameful acts. Walfasha, and all shameful acts. Innahu min ibadina al-mukhlasin, verily, he was from among chosen bondsmen. This is not mukhlasin. Some people have mistranslated it, sincere. Mukhlis is something else. Mukhlas is something else. Mukhlis is ismul fa'il. And mukhlas is ismul maf'ul. And he was one of those whom we have chosen. وَاسْتَبَقَ الْبَابِ, both of them raced towards the door. Hazrat Yusuf tried to run away, and she chased him. وَقَدَّتْ قَمِيصَهُ مِنْ دُبُرٍ, and this chase, you know, she caught hold of the shirt, definitely from the backside, مِنْ دُبُرٍ, and it was torn. وَأَلْفَيَا سَيِّدَهَا لَذَا الْبَابِ, and it came to happen that they found the Sayyid, the master, you know, the husband of that woman, he was on the door. Now, look to the intelligence of this woman. قَالَتْ مَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ أَرَادَ بِأَهْلِكَ سُوءًا, she said, oh, what should be the recompense of the one who tried to have something bad and ill with your wife, who tried to assault your wife. إِلَّا يُسْجَنَا, except this, that he should be imprisoned أو عذاب أليم or some other painful torment. قال هي راودتني عن نفسي. Yusuf said, it is she who tried to seduce me sexually. وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِهَا. Now this is very important. Both of them, you know, two just persons. They appear to be very just. Now a person from her family, in Ahliha, min Ahliha, belonging to her family, he gave a witness, he gave a testimony. إِنْ كَانَ قَمِيْسُهُ قُدَّ مِنْ قُبُلٍ. If his shirt is torn from the front, فَصَدَقَتْ, then she is correct. She is telling the truth. وَهُوَ مِنْ الْكَاذِبِينَ. And he is from among the liars. وَإِنْ كَانَ قَمِيْسُهُ قُدَّ مِنْ دُبُرٍ. And if his shirt has been torn from the back, فَكَذَبَتْ, then she is telling a lie. وَهُوَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. And whatever he is saying is true. وَلَمَّا رَأَى قَمِيْسَهُ قُدَّ مِنْ دُبُرٍ. And when he saw that the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salatu was salam was torn from the back, قَالَ إِنَّهُ مِنْ كَيْدِكُنْ. Immediately he said, to his wife, it is from your machinations, from your guile. إِنَّ كَيْدَكُنَّ عَظِيمٌ. Verily, the machinations and guiles of you women are very great. Yusuf Aridan Haza. Now we appeal to Yusuf. You just ignore it. Don't mention this to anybody. Just, you know, keep quiet about it. And just ignore it. Yusuf Aridan Haza. وَاسْتَغْفِرِي لِذَنْبِكِ. And he said to his wife, and you should beg pardon of your sin, of your ill deed. And إِنَّكِ كُنْتَ مِنَ الْخَاطِئِينَ. Verily, you were the evildoer, and you were the guilty. وَقَالَ نِسْوَةٌ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ اِمْرَاتُ الْعَزِيزِ تُرَابِدُ فَتَاهَا عَنْ نَفْسِي. Now this, you know, this news broke and reached that higher society. Because, you know, the aristocrats in that society, the begamat, you know, the wives, now they were talking to each other. قَالَتْ نِسْوَةٌ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ اِمْرَاتُ الْعَزِيزِ تُرَابِدُ فَتَاهَا عَنْ نَفْسِي. What has happened to this wife of this chief minister, prime minister, chief executive officer? She wants to seduce her slave. قَدْ شَغَفَهَا حُبَّا. Verily, he has incited in her, aroused in her intense love for him. قَدْ شَغَفَهَا حُبَّا. إِنَّا لَنْرَاهَا فِي ذَلَالِ مُبِينَ. We see her. She has gone very, very away from and very manifestly in, you know, error. فَلَمَّا سَمِعَتْ لِمَكْرِهِنَّ. And when she, Zalekha, the wife of that chief minister or Aziz of Misr, when she heard about مَكْرِهِنَّ, their malicious talk, أَرْسَلَتْ إِلَيْهِنَّ. She sent for them all to a banquet. وَعَتَتْ لَهُنَّ مُتَّكَانَ. And arranged a banquet for them. وَعَتَتْ كُلَّ وَاحِدَةٍ مِّنْهُنَّ سِكِّينًا. And gave to every one of them a knife to cut the fruits, etc. وَقَالَتْ أُخْرُجْ عَلَيْهِنَّ. قَالَتْ أُخْرُجْ عَلَيْهِنَّ. And he then commanded to Yusuf, now come out before them. Maybe for service or something else. فَلَمَّا رَأَيْنَهُ. When all of them saw him, أَكْبَرْنَهُ. They exalted him very much. وَقَطَّعْنَا أَيْدِيَهُنَّ. And they cut their hands. Now, not by mistake, please note, قَطَّعْنَا. قَطَّعَ يُقَطِّعُ تَقْطِيعًا. It is from tafheel. It can only be willfully doing it. Each one of them wanted to draw the attention of Yusuf alayhi salam to him. It's just possible that one might have cut by mistake. And because Hazrat Yusuf, you know, he turned to her and, you know, attending her. So every one of them, you know, now cut the fingers or head. Intentionally, قَطَّعْنَا أَيْدِيَهُنَّ. وَقُلْنَ هَاشَا لِلَّهِ. And they cut their hands in amazement and exclaim, Allah blameless, هَاشَا لِلَّهِ, مَا هَذَا بَشَرًا. This is not a mortal human being. إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا مَلَكٌ كَرِيمٌ. He is none but a noble angel. قَالَتْ فَذَلِكُنَّ الَّذِي لُمْتُنَّنِي فِيهِ. Now she said, this is the one about whom you had been blaming me. وَلَقَدْ رَاوَدْتُهُ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ. And surely, indeed, I tried to seduce him, first awesome. But he held back. He held himself. He abstained. And if he is not going to do what I am asking him to do, لَيُسْجَنَنَّ he will definitely be put in the prison. وَلَيَكُونَمْ مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ and he will become the degraded, from the degraded ones. Now hearing all this conversation, Hazrat Yusuf is hearing it. Now he turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prayer. قَالَ رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ O Allah, my Lord, prison is more preferable to me than the way to which these women are calling me. يَدْعُونَنِي Now here is again plural. Not only that wife of Al-Aziz, but all these women. The society was corrupt. The higher society, that was absolutely corrupt. What is happening to the Royal Society of Britain? Royal family of Britain. All these stories, you know. All along with the confessions, clear confessions, on the media, throughout the world. So actually, she was not very much ashamed of what she did. She clearly said, yes, yes, I did it. But he held back. He abstained. He didn't respond. But now, if he doesn't respond in future, I'm bent upon it. And if he doesn't respond positively, he'll be put in prison. Now what she said, رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ O my Lord, prison is preferable to me than to what they are calling me. وَإِلَّا تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَهُنَّ And if you don't turn away from me their machinations, أَصْبُهِنَّ إِلَيْهِنَّ It's just possible that I might incline towards them. وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ And then I will become from the ignorance. I'll be the loser. You know, after all, I'm a human being. And you're seeing, you know, to their machinations. They can go to the extent of cutting their hands so that I can have any attention towards them. So maybe if they continue, one after the other, all these means, maybe I might slip. أَصْبُ إِلَيْهِنَّ Maybe I incline towards them. فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ So his Lord accepted his prayer. فَصَرَفَ عَنْهُ كَيْدَهُنَّ And he turned away from him their machinations. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ Verily, he is all listening, all knowing. ثُمَّ بَدَا لَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا رَأَوُ الْآيَاتِ And then it came to occur to them. It appeared to them to be advisable. Even after seeing all these signs, he had seen for himself, the chief minister, what had happened in his house. He knew it. He had himself said, you are guilty, to his wife. And he had said to Hazrat Yusuf, now just ignore it. Let it go away. But now they thought, and this is actually the public safety now. For the public safety, he must be put into the prison. Because, you know, we can't hold back our women. So it's better that he should be put in the prison. These are the laws, safety laws in so many countries. The TADA. TADA, you know, TADA. TADA in India. And there's going to be, and it's under, you know, legislation, legislative process, undergoing different stages. The Omnibus Anti-Terrorist Act. Anybody, any American, either a citizen or an alien, you know, if he's a citizen, he could be put to prison without proving any charge against him. And if he is an alien, he can be just turned out from the country. Without proving. Now nothing was proved against him. ثُمَّ بَدَا لَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا رَأَوُ الْآيَاتِ لَيَسْجُنَنَّهُ حَتَّىٰ حِينَ It is better, more advisable to put him in the prison for some time to come. وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانَ And with him entered the prison two youths. قَالَ أَحَدُهُمَا One of them said to him, إِنِّي أَرَانِي آثِرُ خَمْرًا I see in my vision myself pressing wine. وَقَالَ الْآخَرُ And the other one said, إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَحْمِلُ فَوْقَ رَاسِي خُبْزًا I see in my vision, in my dream, that I am carrying bread on my head. تاخذ الطير منه and the birds are eating it from it. نبينا بتاويله. Tell us the interpretation of this dream. إنا نراك من المحسنين. We see you to be a very good character man. You are a very good man. You don't seem to be criminal like ourselves, you know. In the prison, all others are criminals, but you are a different type of person. You seem to be a very gentle person, knowledgeable person. So actually, if you can, please tell us the interpretation.
قال لا ياتيكما طعام ترزقانه الا نباتكما بتاويله قبل ان ياتيكما.
He said, the food which comes to you, which is given to you every day, the ration in the prison, now today, when that food is given to you, before that time, I will tell you the interpretation of your dreams. What does it mean? He wanted to borrow some time, to buy some time. Because now they had turned to him, he wanted to preach to them the truth of the deen. Because after all, he was son of a prophet, Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam. He was fully grown, he was 17 when he was taken away from his home. So he knew his grandfather Ibrahim, great-grandfather Ibrahim, and his grandfather Ishaq, and his father Yaqub, and what is the creed, what they believe in it, and what is the belief that he had. So he wanted to preach it.
ذَلِكُمَا مِمَّا عَلَّمَنِي رَبِّي.
And this is from what my Lord has taught me. He is not taking the credit for himself. This is another thing, you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught me these things. He kept me there in the house of the chief minister. I was there in that society, topmost society. I had the occasions to learn things, to interpret the things. But all things were arranged for me by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody could have done it to me without his command.
ذَلِكُمَا مِمَّا عَلَّمَنِي رَبِّي إِنِّي تَرَكْتُ مِلَّةَ قَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ كَافِرُونَ.
I have left the creed of those people who don't believe in Allah, and also they reject Akhirah. They don't believe in resurrection. They don't believe in the hereafter.
وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ.
And I have now consciously, although he was a son or a grandson or a great grandson of the prophets, but now, when he comes of an age, now this is actually a conscious rejuvenation or revitalization of faith. Conscious. So he says, وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ. And I have followed, I have decided to follow the creed of my forefathers, my fathers Ibrahim and Ishaq and Yaqub.
مَا كَانَ لَنَا نُشْرِكَ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ.
It's not worthy of us. It's not befitting for us that we should associate anything with Allah.
ذَلِكَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا.
This is a grace or bounty of Allah to us. He made us superior to every other creature. On us means especially on Ibrahim, Ishaq, Yaqub and me, but on the all of humanity. Because you know they were created as vastulants of Allah on earth. And all the angels were made to prostrate before Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And we should now associate certain things, you know, to with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try to and start worshipping them. It's not befitting for us.
ذَلِكَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا وَعَلَى النَّاسِ
and on all the people, all the mankind. وَلَكِنْ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ. But most of the people are not thankful.
يَا صَاحِبَ السِّجْنِ.
Oh, two of my companions in the prison.
أَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ خَيْرُنَ مِنْ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَارِ.
You think for yourself. Are so many scattered gods better?
Or the one, Allah, the one who is all powerful, who controls everything, who has power over everything.
If you have to serve so many masters, is it easy? To serve one master, it's very easy. You know what are his priorities, what are his preferences. But you know, if you have to serve two, maybe their preferences and priorities clash with each other. So to whom to serve and whom to deny, you'll be in a fix. So,
أَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ خَيْرٌ أَمِ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَارِ.
ماں پرابودون امندون اللہ آسمان سمے تم وہاں تم واب آؤ. آل دیز گاڈز ہوم یو آر ورشپنگ لیونگ الون اللہ لیونگ اوے اللہ بسائڈز اللہ دے آر ناٹ ایکسپٹ اونلی نیمز وچ یو ہیو نیمڈ اینڈ کنکاکٹڈ اینڈ انوینٹڈ یو اینڈ یور فور فادرز. ماں ادر اللہ بہا من سلطان اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی ہیز ناٹ سینڈ ڈاؤن ریگارڈنگ اینی آف دوز اینی اتارٹی اینی الحکم الا للہ سوورنٹی دی کمانڈ دی ایبسلوٹ رائٹ آف اوبیڈینس از ٹو اللہ اینڈ اللہ الون اینی الحکم الا للہ امر اللہ تعبد الا ایاہ اینڈ ہی ہیز کمانڈیڈ دیٹ یو ول ناٹ اوبے یو ول ناٹ ورشپ اینی بڈی ایکسپٹ می. ذالک الدین القیم دس از دی اسٹریٹ دین دس از دی رائٹ سسٹم آف لائف ولکن اکثر الناس لا یعلمون بٹ موسٹ آف دی پیپل نو ناٹ. بارک اللہ لی ولکم فی القرآن العظیم ونفعنی وإیاکم بالآیات والذکر الحکیم.
اللہ اکبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.